Thank you. Thank you so much for bringing us to where we are right now at this moment on this stage. Please be with us, help us to be a beautiful graduation ceremony, and please be with each one of us as we head out into the world starting this afternoon. Thank you to all the people who brought here safely, and please be with those who are still traveling, and help us to always be here in our hearts. In this precious and holy name we pray.
Ladies and gentlemen, teachers, parents, fellow students, family members, and friends, welcome to the graduation of Highland New Academy's Class of 2016. There's not much to say other than thank you. Many of you have been there for our entire lives, others for the majority of it, and some for at least part of it. If not, it is a little weird that you're here. But for those who are here, it is thanks to you that we are able to be on the stage graduating today. Your emotional, intellectual, and financial assistance has been the foundation for our success of being able to at least pass. A 2.0 GPA is hard to come by and can't spell the word mom. So thank you, mothers and fathers, and how does that spell it? Be proud. Thank you for attending the culmination of your hard work. Welcome to the graduation of the class of 2016. Name is we have followed, now we lead.
The class of 2016 motto is the way to correct wrongs of the past is to live for today.
Class of 2016's text and verse reads like this: Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young shall utterly fall, but those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount upon wings like eagles, they shall run and not be weary, they shall walk and not faint. Isaiah 30:31.
Something new. But there was so much more to it than just what freshman year brought. Sophomore few short weeks, the division ceased to exist, and we became the loud, proud, and united Highland you have had in the class of 2016. As I look back over these 4 years, I would not want to be part of any other class. Not because the other classes are anything bad, but because the class of 2016 has become a family, my family, divided by difference, but brought together by change. Of all the things I've learned during my education at HBA, the most profound lesson I've learned is the importance of being earnest. I'm still not. The most profound lesson that I've learned in high school is the importance of change in our lives. Change results in new circumstances we must encounter and new experiences we must face. It allows us to become stronger people and more intellectual thinkers. It helps us to become better companions for each other and teaches us how to support and comfort each other during challenging times. If nothing ever changed, and we were static beings in an unchanging world, we would never grow, never mature, and never develop into the people that God intends for us to be. And no matter how hard we work to avoid change and keep ourselves within the safe haven we so naturally wish to reside, it is unavoidable. Every change will change us. And we need to learn to embrace change, because if we don't, we fight the inevitable, therefore delaying the immaculate and perfect intentions and plans that God has for our lives. It is change. The change from school, whether to middle to high school or during high school. The change from our ways of thinking, the change from our maturity, the change of our class dynamics, changes and challenges in each of our personal lives that has brought us together and developed us into the United Class of 2016 that is filled with so many amazing and inspiring individuals. It is also change that will allow us to further progress in what God has called us to do. While some of the plans we set for ourselves may sometimes go off track and we're unsure of how to survive this unexpected curve in our life journey, it is these changes that help us grow, mature, gain experience, and learn in which there's no other way to learn and gain wisdom. Each of us is about to experience a huge change in our lives, leaving high school and embarking on separate journeys. This change is about to teach us so many new things. How to maintain friendships, how to let go, how to further develop as open-minded individualists, and how to become closer to what God wants us to be. These changes will continue throughout our lives, no matter how old we get, and will constantly be providing the opportunity for us to develop as people. We have to remember that change is inevitable, growth is intentional, and life is developmental. We have to keep growing, and we have to keep embracing change. Praise God for what He's allowed us to do and accomplish, and thank Him for what He has in store for us. To my class, thank you for being part of one of the most memorable times of my life. Thank you for becoming like a family to me, and thank you for being the best class Highland Academy has ever seen. To my family, my teachers, and those who helped me to have the opportunity to go to HBA, thank you for caring. Thank you for seeing greatness and potential in me even before I could. Thank you for everything you've done. Mom and Dad, thank you for not listening. I'm so sorry. Thank you for not listening to me when I told you I wanted to come home, and thank you for seeing and knowing that the best opportunities and method of growth for me would be for me to stay at HBA, even when I missed home so desperately. Thank you for never giving up on me, and thank you for always having my back. Katie, thank you for being the kind, sweet little sister you are, and for sending me sweet notes and text messages sometimes. I love you, Dad, Mom, Katie, and all of my family, both related and unrelated. And I love you, kind of, for having me. I want to tell other people, somebody told me that you only graduated from high school once, this is definitely true, so let's go 2016.
On behalf of the class of 2016, I would like to welcome all faculty, staff, alumni, family, friends, distinguished guests, and most importantly, fellow classmates, to the event that we have all been waiting for so long. I want to start by saying a huge thank you to everyone who has helped us get to where we are today. I would especially like to thank Mrs. McKean and the kitchen crew, because we all know that it is an extreme challenge to feed 120 teenagers.
Thank you.
This class that stands before you today has overcome a lot of struggles. We started out as little, immature, loud kids. Looking at us now, I guess not much has changed. As freshmen, we had no idea that we would go through five principals, teachers that we swore were trying to fail us, and numerous other challenges. We never gave up, though. I've always admired that about our class. No matter what the obstacles, we always find a way to persevere. Out of all the characteristics that our class has, one really sticks out to me: passion. In everything we did, we gave our best, because we believed that was the only option. Even as freshmen, we gave every Campus Cup event our all, because we truly believed that we could win. We took pride in singing our verse in Welcome Table, even though not a lot of other people did. If we believed that we were right, then we stuck to it 100%, even if it did mean our whole class getting a whole week's worth of detention. True story, actually. But I think the more impressive part is the fact that we all got out of it. All right, I'm going to talk to my class now because you guys are my favorite. Class of 2016, it has truly been an honor to have been your president. I'm really going to miss you guys. I knew that we had something special at the first scavenger hunt when we gave it everything because we were so convinced that we could beat those upperclassmen, even though we didn't. That's okay. Because we came back and we won later. Yeah, and again. I have loved every second of being in our wonderful class, and not because we all seem to have a special bond with each other, but because of the way we approach things. It wasn't us versus each other, it was us versus everyone else. We stood together through everything. I'm going to miss the friendships that we have made. And Chiefs, I might even miss your jokes. We did it, guys. But we didn't do it alone. We all had someone to lean on.
Thank you. HBA. Mr. Gadsden is a native New Yorker, a ferocious reader, a basketball coach, and a gymnast. He has worked in Hawaii, California, and Maryland while living in many other states. He came to Highland View Academy in the fall of 2013, where he worked for 2 years as a history teacher. And what makes us love Mr. Gadsden is the year when he taught our sophomore class Bible 2 and World History. There's not one teacher that I can think of that can contain and entertain our entire class for 2 periods in a row, which adds up to 160 minutes of class time, except for Mr. Gadsden. His promotion for discussions, enthusiasm of his kids, and the passion for what he taught made us come to love him as our teacher, and to this day, I can still remember our very first Bible class when we talked about Ephesians 5. It was there that he predicted Louis Bernalis and I to get married, and he even said, "I can't wait to get invited to that wedding." Well, Mr. Gadsden, guess who is my marriage project partner? Mr. Gadsden is married to lovely Carrie and father to the man child CJ while currently living in California. Since his time at HEA, Mr. Gadsden has worked at Prince George's Public School System, started his own consulting firm, and changed career paths. What has not changed is his love for serving God, his passion for young people, and challenging himself to never be a single-digit person. Please welcome Mr. Gadsden.
First off, quickly, I have to do a couple of technical things here. My wife is in California, so I'm going to record my sermon speech so she gets to see it in real time, so I hope y'all don't mind. And then the other thing is, Derek, do you remember that registration day that we decided we were going to figure out who's getting what class? And you told me that you had to have Jefferson first thing in the morning? I don't think anything's changed. 2016. I don't know what to say. I really don't. That lean on me? Priceless. I don't know who got that on video tape, but that's coming back at somebody's wedding, somebody's kid's graduation. But that right there is the embodiment of what it means to go to an average education school. That's what it means. See, I have to do a couple other house cleaning things. First off, all the transplants that I didn't have the privilege to teach, you're now my children. You've now been adopted into this family. All of them right there, they were mine when I was here. Now you're mine too. You ever see me? Ask me. I love you. To the families that are representing these transplants, welcome to HBA. Welcome to the families. I was telling one of the fathers that I was disappointed on my drive up this morning because I didn't get to see my Rolling Thunder parade as they went down the road. Seeing as how tomorrow is the day in which we celebrate Memorial Day, I'd like to take a moment and thank every veteran and current member of our military and for our police force, firefighter, who is serving to protect our right to do this peacefully. God's word, we're going to begin with our sermonic spots.
Luke chapter 5, verses 1 through 11. Those of you with the electronic Bibles, y'all feel free to get them out, because I know most of you didn't bring the big one. Class, that includes you. By the way, hashtag payday delay. He's talking, and he's preaching. He's walking about the Sea of Galilee, and he is looking for a place to relax. But Jesus never gets time to relax because the crowds are following him. This is the time period in which Luke tells us the first four disciples joined Jesus. But I want to show you a couple of things. Luke chapter 5, verses 1 and 2. So it was, as the multitude pressed about him to hear the word of God, that he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two boats standing by the lake. But the fishermen had gone from them and were washing their nets. Then he got into one of the boats, which was Simon's, and asked him to put out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the multitude from the boat. When he had stopped speaking, he said to Simon, "Launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a catch." Now we know what happened next. He got a catch. But not just an ordinary catch. He got a catch that was so significant, it started to sink his boat, so he had to call his partners out, and it started to sink their boat. Now, see, I want you to understand something. Jesus got in the boat and then said, "Simon, I need you to move us out of here." I'm going to let that sink in for a moment. Go ahead. Think about that for a moment. See, I tell my students all the time, I never ask a question without having already provided the answer. So what's the answer? See, the answer is very simple. Simon's payday was delayed because remember, he had been out on the water the all night long fishing and came up empty. Now we're talking about a master fisherman. See, because Simon Peter and his brothers and James and John and Andrew weren't smart enough to make it in rabbi school. See, none of y'all got that problem because y'all got caps and gowns on. Oh, wait. There were a couple of you who might have been struggling. What did you say, Travis? The people trying to fail you? Now, I have to remind all of you, you earn what you get. You might want to do more work when you get to college. Just a thought. I'm just saying, college is a little expensive. I mean, when they talk about graduation, debt being $30-something plus, you might want to study. Just a thought. Who knew? Mr. and Mrs. Dallas, y'all remember that? Remember that parent-teacher conference we had? Remember? Look at that. Look at that. Now, I will get into this a little more, but I first have been remiss. I need to pray. We need to invite God. Father God, I thank you for your grace. I thank you for the class of 2016. I thank you for Highland Youth Academy. I thank you for the administrators who are here with the foresight to do your bidding. I thank you for the colleagues who sit in the classrooms, who teach in the classrooms, who deal with these young men and women who struggle from day to day with just figuring out what it is you want them to do. But Father, I pray in a very special way for a blessing on them. I pray for a blessing on the parents who were willing to sacrifice for their child to be here at this location for such a time as this. We thank you for the words that are about to be spoken. We thank you that they're going to come from the throne of grace. And I thank you for the privilege to be here and to be your servant at this moment. We praise your name in Jesus' name.
Amen. He's up there in glory. Because as the old spiritual says, I'm just passing through. If you want to stay, just let me by. I got to go. Class of 2016, if you want to stay, let me by. I got to go. But I know this class. As was said by Courtney, I didn't control you. That was the Holy Spirit. We just had fun. We did what God wanted us to do. Whether it was world history or Bible, we were in a group setting because God wanted us together for such a time as that. Whatever the experiences you had were your experiences because God needed you to have those experiences. Y'all know what happened in my dream, but the truth of the matter is that my dream has led me to a place in which now I understand that part of what God wanted me to do was to go into ministry. See, I thought I was doing that. I really did. Standing in front of you all every day. But what I realized is that, as my father-in-law said, see, Courtney, you know that single digit thing? My father-in-law actually said single digit midget. That's what he actually said. And they all know I'm over 6 foot tall, so I'm not a midget from the back. And I apologize if anybody felt slighted by that. But the simple fact of the matter is that my father-in-law was trying to remind me that my talents cannot be contained by a single opportunity. There is not a single person in here who should be contained by what you're currently doing. Because if you are, you need a reality check. Because last time I checked, Jesus Christ was not defined by the walls that we put him in, nor the box that you try to leave him in so he doesn't make you feel uncomfortable. Because last time I checked, he's all about making people feel uncomfortable. Right? I told you we're going to church, you can say amen. I mean, if you believe it, you can say amen. Because the truth of the matter is this. This group up here didn't get there without you. Without you being willing to tell them, Jesus Christ is the rock. Jesus Christ is the Savior. The Holy Spirit will get you through. Kayla, your mother knew the reason why you needed the Savior, because the Holy Spirit was attacking that. Not one of you is he, because it's an accident. Not one of you. There are some in this class who I was wondering if they would ever get their acts together. I really do. I don't think any of them actually did. Because as I saw them coming down the aisle, I realized that that joy that had been incessant in them stayed. Because that's what God needed them to have. See, you don't have hyperactive children. You have God. See, and that energy that God has given them is energy that will finish his work so we can go home. Because I'm tired. And I see some of you out here older than I am who are definitely tired and ready to go. So I got a challenge for you. Push them. Because they are the ones who need to finish this work. We have to do our part, but they've got to finish. See, the truth of the matter is this. Let me show you what I mean by payday delay. Turn to Hebrews chapter 11. Those of you who have your electronic Bibles will get there before I will, but that's okay. Hebrews chapter 11, verses 39 to 40. Last two verses of this particular chapter, known as the faith chapter. Check this out. Class, pay close attention to what's about to be said. And all of these, having obtained a good testimony through faith, did not receive the promise. God having provided something better for us, that they should not be made perfect apart from us. Class, I'm going to tell you this right now. Some of us may not see glory when Jesus comes while we're still breathing. But don't worry. You keep the faith, God's got something special for you. That payday delay that I'm talking to you about, that's what's special. Because it's special for you. John chapter 14, verses 1 through 3 tells us that Jesus is building a mansion unique to each and every one of you and each and every one of us here. See, it can't be the same as Sarah. It can't be the same as Julianne. Because guess what? Even though you two are some really good friends, going all the way back to Frederick days, you're still unique in the eyes of God. I used to tease Mike Barron about being on time to class. But I ain't got to worry about that. Mike could be in the kingdom just like everybody else. No, you won't be late, buddy. If you're late, you're not there. You'll be on time. Now, I do have to talk about this class for a real brief minute. Kayla alluded to this in sort of traffic. This class is not a class that can be identified by a single item. They are just who they are. Since they came as freshmen, they have challenged the status quo. When I got here, I had my juniors, and they wrecked us in every athletic, academic opportunity we had. My class kept looking up and saying, we got to be able to beat this class. I kept looking at them like, y'all got to work harder. When the class of 2014 thought they were at the top of the mountain, this class pushed them. Y'all know they did. When they got their junior, I'm pretty sure they pushed. When you got to be seniors, I'm pretty sure nobody got close. But see, seeing as how you have always bucked the status quo, there should be no problem with y'all changing the world. Because you've never been about what the world has been about. Last night I was online wrapping up this
this address, and I came across an address from a young man by the name of Donovan Livingston. He gave a speech at Harvard University during the graduation address, which Harvard itself has called the most powerful speech you will ever hear. A speech that has been seen by 8.8 million people since it went online. In it, he talks about his experience. And one of the really interesting things that he says is this: I have been a black hole in the classroom for far too long, absorbing everything without allowing my light to escape. But those days are done. I belong among the stars, and so do you, and so do they. Together we can inspire galaxies of greatness for generations to come. No sky is not the limit. It is only the beginning. Lift off. Class of 2016, your duty now is to lift off, to go to the highest heights, to never allow somebody to tell you you can't do something, because all you got to say is, yes, I can, God said so. It is your opportunity now. It is your privilege to walk down these stairs, to walk out those doors, and tell the world, hey, guess what? You're about to change. My challenge to this class is very simple. There is no height that you cannot achieve. There is no obstacle that you cannot overcome. There is no place that you cannot go that God has not already been, and he has not already seen you. My advice to you is very simply this: remember the words of your verse, which happens to be one of my favorites. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But those whose payday they're willing to delay will wait on the Lord. He shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. In the words of your pastor, live today the right way and see what Jesus has in store for you. Class of 2016, it has been my privilege and my honor to call you my student. And thank you for the privilege to spend just a little bit of time with you today. Good luck.
I think we all did. Thank you so much, Gadsden, for being here with us today. Today, or right now, we move on to the part where I present an award called the Caring Heart Award. Now, here at our school and all of our schools across the U.S., we encourage our students to participate in community service. We want them to understand the joy and privilege it is to be Jesus' hands to those around us. Now, this award is given to a student who has not only completed the required community service, but above and beyond. The community service that they have begun to do just because they particularly enjoy serving. Also, this award is given to someone who's attitude towards community service is one where they clearly receive a blessing from their service to others. This award also comes with a $500 scholarship to the college of their choice. This year, the Caring Heart Award has been given to Alyssa Joy Taylor.
Pleased to see who your graduation speaker was this morning.
Amen.
Your graduation speaker was actually, when I first went to the university, my student worker at the university. We have three different awards that we're giving out today. We have a Gateway Scholarship that is given out, and all of these scholarships are given out based on the information that we receive at the university from the academy. These scholarships are based on GPA and test scores, standardized test scores. The Gateway Scholarship is a $4,000 per year award for a total of $16,000. The Trustee Scholarship is a $6,000 per year award for a total of $24,000. And the Presidential Scholarship is an $8,000 per year award for a total of $32,000. But the Presidential Scholarship also carries with it an additional $2,000 per year for the Columbia Union Merit Scholarship for graduating from an SCA Academy in the Columbia Union. So the Presidential Award is worth $10,000 per year for a $40,000 total award. So at this time, we would like to recognize those members of your class who are receiving awards this morning. And I would ask if Elder Remmers would step up, and I'm going to have him hand these to you. Elder Remmers is a member of the Board of Trustees of Washington Evans University, and we're pleased that he is here with us as well this morning. To be able to participate with us and recognize these students. So this morning, the first person that is receiving is a $16,000 Trustee Scholarship, and that is Amara Sakabalon. $56,000 is Alyssa Tangler. are out here trying to do the calculations, the graduating class just received scholarship in the amount of $256,000. Take this time and become what God has called you to do. Blessing to you.
Also said the scholarships. Our students are talented group. They have worked hard. And I will say they have quite a few opportunities. So at this time, several teachers will help me pass out scholarships for our other members.
From South Boston Adams University, awarded to Jacob Hantown, right back here, $4,000 for this.
$40,000
to Justin Byers.
$48,000 to Alyssa Tangway. $48,000 to Courtney Tooley.
$1 million.
Sierra University. I attended there to see my graduate degree stand. Cliff Gadsden, who is my fellow graduate at La Sierra University, will be helping me cast. So, starting with Pacific Union College, in the amount of $48,000, spent in late.
Thank you. graduating with high honors, Travis Andrew Calhoun. Graduates, Alyssa Joy Tangway.
Thank you.
Aaron.
Michael Ryan Dallas.
Thank you.
with high honors, Matias Hector Olivares.
I felt it was important to focus on one important charge. guys are reading me books and I took some. As you enter this world as young men and women, prepare to serve in many capacities. Never forget your potential. Never let anyone tell you that you are not good enough, or not able, or cannot complete the task. You have been prepared, and you have the greatest gift of all, a Lord and Savior who will follow you and prepare you to do all things according to his great service. I want to remind you that wherever you go in your lives, you are sons and daughters of the living God. That you are most special, and the charge I want to leave you with today, although in most graduation speeches it is to go out, be successful, accomplish, but as Pastor Zeke reminded us, what is that true success? That true success is that when we see the Lord coming in the air, we are all together. I charge you to be with us all on that day. Stay close to Jesus. Invite him into your heart and keep him there close in every choice and every decision throughout your life until we all go home to our true home. For this world is not our home. We are passing through. The heavens are laid out somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from the feathers of the door. And I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Please join us all in 2016. Let's be in heaven together.
After all, they've been waiting for 17 years, some 16 17, some 18, once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to share their excitement once they become a senior. Just give me a few seconds.
One, two, three.
Okay.
come on, let's go. 27.
Come on.